What do you know about RF and how the human body reacts to exposure? Chances are you've heard about it and the health effects associated with exposure. While short-term exposure to RF waves does have an effect on the human body, the only established adverse health effects associated with exposure in that frequency range from 3 kHz to 300 GHz is centralized tissue heating and nerve stimulation in the area of exposure. Currently, there is no research that supports a claim that RF exposure results in acute, chronic, and/or cumulative harmful effects at levels at or below the regulation limits. This course does not apply to the deliberate exposure for treatment of patients by or under the direction of medical practitioners. Employers often include a written RF policy in their HSE manual. This RF program will typically identify sources for training, medical monitoring, personal protective equipment, engineered controls, signs, hazard assessment, and employee responsibilities. When completing an RF hazard assessment, some of the questions that must be answered include: what is the source of the RF? What is the frequency of the RF source? How will the source be encountered? And what is the power output? Answering these questions will lead to the selection of PPE and controls that should be used to protect against overexposure if one exists. It is a good rule of thumb when working around antennas to presume that all antennas are active.